Are you looking to maximize your note-taking in 2025? Well, you've got to try Google Notebook LM. And in today's video, I'm going to show you everything that you need to know about it, how to get started, and five amazing examples of how you can use it in your daily routine. Notebook LM is one of the most powerful AI note-taking tools right now, and Google seemingly continue to invest in it as a way for you to take your notes to the next level. Today, I wanted to show you how you can get started and how you can use it in five different ways to boost your daily productivity and to save you a bunch of time. This guide will be the comprehensive resource for you to go out there and start taking advantage of Notebook LM and using it in your routine. So welcome, my name is Francesco. If you're new to the channel, do subscribe to Toolfinder and jump over to toolfinder.co to explore plenty more tools like this. You can find that linked below. There's also an AI productivity guide, which you can find below to maximize your productivity using artificial intelligence like this. So all you need for Notebook LM to get started is a Google account. Now you can have whatever account you want. In my case, I'm using a Workspace account, but you can access it on pretty much anything. And there are actually two packages to Google Notebook LM now, and that is a regular package, which gives you access to all of the features, but there's also an additional package, which is called Plus. You need Google Gemini for this, so I'll include some more details about that. That gives you more access, more abilities, and also is much faster, apparently, to be able to use. So good that Google's investing in this product. So for those getting started, let's create a notebook. Now, this is what appears when you're getting started, and it's very much adding the sources. The sources are like the fuel for using this. So you can add a few different type of sources. You can add PDFs, Markdown, and audio in any format. And you can also add things that are part of your Google account, like a Google Docs or a Google Slides, a website or YouTube video, or even some copied text. You get a limit of 50 sources, which is pretty good. And if you want to add more, you can add them by pressing up here and minimize them if you want them to go away. Now, this central area here is actually your where you actually communicate with your sources. So this is incredibly helpful because this is where all of the recommendations are going to come through. And as you add your sources, it's going to be even more helpful. And over in here, the thing that you may have seen on social media is the audio overview, where you can generate a podcast with two AI hosts instantly. And it allows you not only to generate it, but to customize it and give it some prompts, which we'll explore a little bit later. Now down here, anything you want to add, you can create a note. These notes are really simple and you can convert them to a source at any given point if they become even more valuable as you use them. Now in the studio, you will also be able to use a study guide, which turns all of the sources and your notes so far into a study guide, which turn into a note down here, as well as an FAQ, a timeline, and a briefing document, which are all incredibly useful resources to getting started. Now you can share your notebook at any given time using the copy link up in the top right-hand corner. And there's a settings area as well to change to light and dark mode if you feel that takes your fancy. So now we've got the basics out of the way. You can rename stuff and edit the title, but let me show you my first example. The first example is journal and feelings. Now you may want to reflect on your feelings every single day. So here's a great way to do it. Now, sometimes entering information can be obviously private information. So just make sure you're comfortable sharing that information before you do. But I copied in five pieces of text that were generated from a journal that I generated through ChatGPT that essentially were journal entries for 4 days. Now, what's interesting as well is you can use the source guide here and it instantly breaks down those emotions and key topics that are part of the source. So that's incredible already. So that's really useful because if you would just upload a source and you weren't aware of all of the information from it, you could analyze each source before you even jump in, which is incredibly helpful. So in this case, the journal entry indicated that there was tension between fear of the unknown and anticipation for growth. That's something I might not have been able to understand fully from my own note, which was a journal. There's also key topics as well, which it extracts out. Now, you can also do this for any of the other sources you've got. In this case, I've only done paste to text, but you could export your entire journal as a markdown and upload up to 50 sources as part of that. Now you can see here that the chat is dramatically changed. Let me minimize the sources for a second. You can see here now, based on all of the four sources, those 4 days that I journaled, it indicates that there were mixed feelings of sadness, optimism, and nervousness. So this is a really good one. It was a way to really quickly get a summary for it. So what you can do here is save that note. And as I said, those notes appear here and they also get a title instantaneously. So that's helpful for getting a summary of everything, but you can also start communicating with this. You could say, what are some of the ways I can combat these feelings? And it's going to pull from all four of those sources to generate an answer based on it. Now that answer, as you can see, it's been broken down and references sources as part of that. So for example, it gives me my first recommendation. Now, of course, this is not going to be your assistant, just FYI, in terms of being an actual therapist. So it could be something that you dig deeper on or you actually combine with other things. But as you can see, it says acknowledge and validate the mixed emotions and gives you some recommended advice. It also gives you 5 pieces of recommended advice, which you can use as part of that. Now you can use as a study guide here. So the study guide is essentially a way to turn those notes into an actionable table of contents that potentially is valuable to you. So let's see what they generated for that. As you can see, it gives you a quiz as well. So for example, this might not be valuable as a study guide, but just as an overview and a feature demonstration, we'll probably show you that with the fasting stuff. You can see what specific concern about the future is mentioned in journal entry 1. So probably not useful for me. So anytime you can delete your notes and the notes will not be stored as part of this down here, which is really helpful. Now, as you can imagine, all of those sources, those notes that you create as part of it can be converted into a source instantly. So if you're taking active notes to improve your active use of this, it then converts it into a source, which is incredibly valuable, adding even more perspective for you to go deeper and deeper. Now, one of the things that you can do is generate the audio overview. Now, for a journal entry, this could be incredibly useful because having two people reflect on your thoughts could be an incredible insight.
Welcome back to the Deep Dive. You know, today we're doing something kind of different. We're diving deep into, well, your world.
Oh, intriguing.
Right. We've got these journal entries chronicling your lead up to a big career change. Last day's coming up fast.
I see. Following someone through this huge life transition.
That reflective activity for somebody that's maybe struggling with their feelings or emotions could be an incredibly valuable exercise. So looking at this as a journal, it can not only be a great way to chat with your emotions and get actionable advice, but also to start taking some notes about how you feel, even potentially using notes in here as a way to bring in your daily journal and having those chats to unpack your feelings and emotion. Now, of course, you can add as many sources as you want. You could say, you could turn a source into pasted text that is week 1, week 2, week 3, and add up to 50 sources, almost a whole year of journaling inside of Notebook LM. So that could be a really interesting perspective because you would be able to keep it inside of one notebook and that could be incredibly useful. So again, another perspective on using this. So one of the next things that you could do is use this as a resume summary. Now, for example, I took my LinkedIn profile, turned it into a PDF by just going print, save as, and a PDF, and I essentially uploaded it. And I, as you can see, you can start to see a breakdown of that. It summarized it. But what I might ask is, what potential career moves are coming up for Francesco? And this could be a great way not only to turn your resume into a useful breakdown, but it could also be a way for you to analyze your entire history. For example, it says expanding his content creation, consultancy and marketing, partnership with SaaS companies, speaking, and it starts to pick out some really useful stuff. Now you can also begin to use the podcast as a way to reflect on how you present yourself online. So if you're looking to improve your online profile, you could upload your Twitter account, your LinkedIn, and start to begin to pull together a resume.
All right, let's jump into another deep dive. This time, we're focusing on Francesco D'Alessio.
So I'm going to hit interactive mode, and this interactive mode will allow me to listen to the podcast.
All right, let's jump into another deep dive. This time, we're focusing on Francesco D'Alessio. He's this pro... Oh, hey, I think our listeners got something to say.
So I'd like to say that I'm Francesco, and I'm looking to better improve my profile. So could you give me a few ways for me to...
You want some specific tips for your LinkedIn profile, right?
Absolutely, and we can totally help with that.
What's fascinating is that your profile is a dynamic resume, so we can look at it with that lens.
Yeah, it's all about telling a story, not just listing things.
Absolutely. If you think about your tool finder role, you can highlight how you help people choose tools, making it a story about problem solving, you know?
Yeah, and you've got a ton of endorsements that back up your claim, so make those very visible, for sure.
Now, one of the other pleasures in my life is Formula One. Now, one of the things that you might want to do before travel or a lifestyle activity or learning a new skill is to embrace some of the knowledge that you've got coming up, but combining two things together. So, for example, let's say hypothetically, I want to travel to Monza, which is the Italian Grand Prix, and I want to teach myself Italian that is relevant to the racetrack. So in this case, I've uploaded a YouTube video called the Italian Grand Prix Travel Guide, as well as a full Teach Yourself Beginner's Italian PDF, which I found online. So as you can see, what it's doing here is giving me recommended advice based on my situation and referencing it as well as part of this. So for example, it says when greeting staff, it is appropriate to use buongiorno until about 4 p.m. and then you would use buonasera. And then you can start to see, for example, if you have a ticket, say, ho un biglietto. And then it gives you more advice surrounding things that you would typically interact around the track. For example, it could be like the race is called La Gara. So you might want to overhear that. For example, La Gara F2, so that you knew that there's an F2 race coming up or something like that. But you get the idea. This can be incredibly helpful as a way to learn. But you can also customize the audio overview. I asked it to focus on basic phrases about how to speak to locals about the race. So what it's going to do is regenerate the podcast based on my objective here to look like I'm speaking Italian to the locals that are at the track. Waiting for that, I also created a briefing guide. And what this did really nicely is not only summarize a YouTube video, which outlines everything about the track, but it combined it with the knowledge of the, for example, the learning Italian and also from the internet. So for example, in this case, the start finish straight, for example, it's telling me, you know, that the grandstands are split sinistra and destra. So if I'm looking at signs, I can look that this is going to be the sinistra grandstand. I don't know whether they straight out like that. And the destra, which is the grandstand to the right. So this can be an incredibly helpful setup when it comes to combining language and the travel. So one of the obvious things as well is study and research. And one of the things that you could do is upload multiple sources like Markdown, documents, and things from websites, YouTube videos, and PDFs. And I've done that with some fasting research. And one of the things that you can do is use this as a study guide. So for example, in this case, studying can become a lot more interactive. And you can not only use the audio and interactive mode that's in beta to interject into the conversation, asking questions that spiral into your head at that given time, you can also use it as a study guide. The study guide is a really helpful way to quiz yourself on specifics. So for example, here you could ask something like, what are some of the potential benefits of intermittent fasting mentioned in the John Hopkins source? And then if you scroll down, you can find the answer, which is linked below. So this is a really incredibly useful guide to starting to ask questions. And you could also start chatting with the resource to better get some insights from that. But this is a really nice combination for those who are studying to really get a better idea of how to take advantage of their notes and use their notes in active learning.
Hey everyone. So I get it. Intermittent fasting is like everywhere these days, right? You're probably thinking, okay, is this just another diet fad? Or is there something real to this? Well, look, hey there. Want to share your thoughts on this?
Is it actually a diet fad at the moment? Is there any data to prove that more and more people are doing it?
That's a great question. And it's totally valid to wonder if this is just a fad.
Yeah, it's important to approach these things with a healthy dose of skepticism, I think.
So while our sources don't really get into the popularity of intermittent fasting as a trend.
Right, they focus more on the science of it all.
They do show there's a renewed interest in fasting practices, though.
We can definitely see that across different cultures, right?
Definitely. There's been a lot of books and online resources popping up on the subject.
It's not. Oh, yeah, uh-huh.
What references to other cultures are there with fasting?
Oh, that's a fantastic question. I'm glad you asked about the cultural aspect.
Yeah, that's a great point to explore. It helps us see that fasting isn't just a modern trend.
Our sources actually touch on several cultural and religious practices involving fasting.
One of the most prominent examples is Ramadan.
One of the examples that could be really helpful is actually taking your business knowledge and improving it. So for example, I've uploaded the current process that we do for a very basic onboarding process to a new employee. Now, it's pretty awful in how we set things up, so maybe you want to improve it and change it. I've also found a YouTube video that essentially outlines how you can pre-onboard people, but also manage a buddy system. The insights are incredibly useful in that. So I'm going to take these two and ask it, can you upgrade our current process of onboarding to a new one with the recommendations of the video? And what you can see here is one that it generated earlier. It started introducing an entire step-by-step guide in how I can turn everything that I learned through the YouTube video into the current process. And I didn't even have to watch the YouTube video. This is an incredibly useful resource because it's pulling from a set specific source that you can use to improve your team. So those are five examples that you can use with Notebook LM. It's a powerful note-taking experience and it's only going to get better. And the more you use it, the more powerful it will become. So you can check out Notebook LM and hopefully this guide gave you everything you need to know about it. If you're searching for AI tools and resources, I'd recommend jumping over to toolfinder.co, the best place for you to find tools on the line. Thank you so much for stopping by. Please do make sure to subscribe and I'll see you in a future video. Cheerio for now.